Welcome back to my channel. It's Marvel Legends time again. So I just picked up the Marvel War Machine. And this is a deluxe figure. You can tell by the packaging, it's a little bit bigger. It's kind of like that Black Widow that had the in the white box where she came with this really cool stand. I was kind of hoping there would be a stand in here, but I don't seem to see one. We'll see when I open. I don't think there's actually a stand. There is something on the back. I don't know if that's just an emblem or anything. I did not try to sneak a peek inside the packaging. So this is War Machine. As you can see, it's Jim Rhodes, right? It does come with quite a few extras, and he looks pretty decked out. What I want to talk about a little bit is Iron Man. So when I was growing up, Iron Man was kind of like one of my go-to comics. Now, this is Assistant Editor's Month, Invincible Iron Man or All New Iron Man. And they did this thing where they had like little kids as like the Avengers and stuff. But at the end, it was Tony Stark, Shame of the City. You know, he's a drunk wandering around. And this is kind of like the beginning of him being like a drunk. So one of the things that happens is Jim Rhodes, he basically puts on the Iron Man outfit. And he goes around, and now he's Iron Man. Now, this one right here is where the Mandarin's sort of taking control of Jim Rhodes and making him do, like, some dirty work and stuff like that. Iron Man versus Iron Man, right? So Jim Rhodes has got the Iron Man costume. Tony Stark comes back. He has to put on one of his old pieces of armor. He uses this really old tech and sort of just proves why he's Iron Man, right? He takes this rudimentary armor and basically defeats Jim Rhodes as Iron Man. So one of the things that we start seeing is now Stark's back as Iron Man, but Jim Rhodes, he kind of doesn't want to give up the mantle. And then we have the spinoff of the West Coast Avengers. And this is about the first time that you start really seeing this version of this outfit. So I have this 286, I'm not saying that this is the first time he's been in this. I'm not 100% sure. But I have this one where he's on the cover. And everybody's like, well, Tony Stark's dead or whatever. Why is this guy Iron Man? So this is the outfit. When I see this, I see this. So I'm going to leave that up for comparison. But I'm pretty sure that this costume, based off of this costume. Let's open this figure up and take a closer look. He's got this War Machine's artwork on the side. Same artwork on this side. And you got this really cool Iron Man outfit or War Machine outfit in here. So let's open this up and get this figure out of the box. Now, I didn't pull everything out of this plastic because during my review today, I'm probably not going to use some of these littler things. And I just don't want to lose them right now. So I'm just going to set those off to the side. I did pull out. What we have here is we have a couple of exhausts with smoke. And they were sort of separate from the pieces that will go on the feet, which are the flames. So they could utilize two purposes because they will sit down in this and become kind of like a stand. You got this piece that's like smoke and these missiles, which is actually kind of cool for a decoration piece. And there's a loose missile here, which is really neat. So if you see the back picture, you see that it's kind of like the tracer fire from his arm machine gun. And he has a second head, which is the unmasked Jim Rhodes. And I'll show that a little bit more close up on top of the figure itself. He's got these side cannons on him that are nice because they have this motion, this little track, which allows them to sit back, and you can sort of tilt them back so they kind of hide behind them or whatever. But they can come up and lock and load into place. I think that's a really cool feature. I do like this headpiece right here, where he's got his, like, maybe laser scope or some sort of a scope vision. And the head tilts back, tilts forward, and has basically some side-to-side motion, which is really cool if you want to do some posing or something like that, or even some stop motion. So the arms have this like really soft, not even attached to his arms. It's like a soft plastic going over the shoulders. The only thing that makes me worry about those at all, I'm gonna pull these off, and they are just basically ball joints, is that where they're connected here, it's just the plastic and it doesn't look like it's on a hinge. So over time, I'm afraid that maybe this might end up tearing off and coming loose. So anyways, having that doesn't hinder his motion a little bit, right? Does a little, but it still allows him to get up about close to 90 degrees, and he can get back a little bit. It does hinder it a little bit, but that's okay. He's got this motion here. He's got that double jointed arm, which gives him more than 90 degrees, which is really nice considering he's in the armor. He's got his fist, and it has good motion. And then this one is a fist also. So you're not putting anything in this guy's hand, but his weapons are all ready to go. Now this arm piece is sort of permanent, and this rifle is soft rubber on the tip, so that's not coming off. He's got good waist movement, and he's got like that upper body motion here, which is pretty good. His leg does not move back at all because of the butt piece, but it does have good forward motion. He's got some good upper leg movement. He does do almost the splits. He's got a double jointed knee, which gives him good range of motion there. And then his lower leg bends and turns, but he does not have any more motion there in his leg. But this is a really good looking figure. I think it has really good modeling. I mean, if you look at this piece here, these are like maybe some vents or something that come in. This is really nice. I wish they would do stuff like some type of a light up LED or something in there, or just paint it with some sort of glow in the dark or something to make it look like it could produce energy. All right, let's see how easy the head comes off. Comes off super easy. You can put that down. Jim Rhodes's head goes on. And he's got his military flat top. You can see where they tried to pretend like he's got the lines in there, where they painted in between the haircut. He's got his nice chin. This head has pretty much the same good motion, side to side, all the way around. I think they did a good job. This is a really good sculpt on that. And I wanna say, I think that is a really good likeness with the colors and the design. And yeah, I really do like this War Machine and the way he compares to that figure. Now I'm gonna put these rifles back on, so give me a second. There you got them. If you have them like flying across, like if he had that stand. But in this case, these just go into the smoke on the ground. So we're showing that off. Here he is with his leg pieces on, with the smoke blowing out. We got this like piece where it looks like he was shooting, moving his arms up. He's firing those rockets off there. I think this looks pretty good if you compare it to that picture in the background. And that's the beginning of the West Coast Avengers. I think it looks really, really good. Anyways, everybody, that's the War Machines, which I keep calling Iron Man because I think it's Iron Man there until he decides to become War Machine. Thanks for tuning in. Subscribe if you haven't already, and come back for more. Thanks a lot, everybody. I appreciate it.